Morning, it's heatwave day. Something a little different for me today to the KTM. I am gonna go down to Dorset to this event for historic World War II military vehicles. And I'm gonna be an outrider on a 1942 Royal Enfield. And this is my little bike. Let me turn some lights on so we can see what's going on in here. So this is my 1942 Royal Enfield WDCO350. And this is what I'm gonna be riding for the event down in Dorset. Okay, so I'm on my way. It's damned hot. I'm about 2 hours behind. Bike's all loaded up onto the trailer. Traffic's looking terrible for the journey down. What should have been about 2 hours is looking about 2.5 hours. Excited to use the old Royal Enfield again. First time used it properly in a couple of years. And it's gonna be good riding up and down along this convoy, stopping the traffic, feeling like that I'm in World War II, even though I'm not. Well, yeah. This is a sight and a half. Look at these. Chaffee tank, half track with 50 cal pods on, Shermans, all sorts. So we got down to Weymouth. Pretty incredible sight actually. Jeeps, we got half tracks, we got diamond tees, we got deuce and a halfs. People in Weymouth have been treated to a real piece of history here, and it's nice to be involved in it again. It's been a few years, say 2016 was the last time this event happened, and it's happening again. So I'll just whiz the camera around so you can see a little bit. Just some incredible pieces of equipment that you just, these are all privately owned as well. They're all restored beautifully. I mean, look at these half tracks with quad 50 calibers on them. They're just sights to behold. And then you got half tracks with, I don't know what caliber they are, I think they're 106 anti-tank guns and things on them. Just again, amazing. Just amazing. I like my KTM, but I tell you what, I like my Jeep and I like my green vehicles as well. So tomorrow we'll have a little bit more in the morning. I'll see if I can get the drone up and I'll show you the bikes. See if I can get my drone up and get an overview of everything. Here's the bikes. All part of that. Some of these guys are fixing one as well. Good old British bike, broke its cable. Anyway, more tomorrow. Going off to the driver's briefing now. There's a lot of very dangerous vehicles here, which obviously could kill. not just come with their guns, but because they're big and they're going to kill people if they crush them. So obviously a lot of inexperienced drivers, especially in a convoy like this. So we're going for a 8 o'clock safety briefing, and then just after that we'll have the briefing for the DRs. Our job obviously is to keep this convoy moving, stop the traffic, make sure the public don't get in the way. That'll be us. And hopefully I'll grab hold of Jack later and we'll have a sit down, talk about how Armour Embarkation happened and what's involved into making this thing run. For now, that's it. Okay, rider, driver briefing over. This is going to be quite an epic event. Hopefully things will run smoothly. We won't get too many cars joining the convoy. So I don't know if I'm going to get time to even get a camera onto the bike. So for now, you're just going to have to put up with what little content I've got. During the day, when I get a bit of time to stop, I will rig up the GoPro. But I've literally got 10 minutes to get my stuff on, get my bike started and over to the start point. But yeah, it's gonna be an amazing sight. As you can see, we're all ready for the off. I'm about the only one actually, so this is a full helmet, yeah, nobody else likes it. But as you can see, everybody's queuing up, ready to go. Us DRs are gonna be blocking the road, and then we're gonna have this almighty great sight behind us. So I'm at the first junction that I'm stopping traffic at. Thankfully, I mean, there's absolutely nothing. We're in the village, but we're waiting for the convoy to come through now, and it's gonna be big. I'll try and get as much of it as possible, but there's about 70 odd vehicles, big armor, small armor, Jeeps, trucks, breakdown trucks. There's artillery pieces. It's just an absolutely incredible sight, and it's amazing to be able to be actually part of this. I don't think the people here in Broadmayne get it, but the people who are going to see this today are going to be in for an absolute treat, that they're not going to realize how rare this is. For me, I've been in the military vehicle world for 20 odd years, and I've never seen this other than at a show where it's all static. To see it is just gonna be amazing. I know I keep saying it, but wait till this comes. Coming past now. It is very, very rare. I don't know what it is, we'll have to find out later. But as you can see behind me, it's coming past. A lot of noise, a lot of action. Stop. We've been in the, oh, I've got a dirty nose, look at that. We've had I've got a dirty face as well. I'm actually really finished them quite badly. I've got this column of vehicles that I don't know if you can see behind me. If I go, look at that. Oh, there we go. Yeah, just there. That is just incredible. And it just keeps going and going and going. Going and going. So we're off to Bovington Tank Museum now. So hopefully at Bovington we can have a little bit of wander around some of these vehicles while they're out and about, and hopefully they have a look at all the bikes as well. I'm hoping I can get my drone up again, but this is just, I'm really dirty. Anyway, we'll come back to you. So we got our first proper breakdown. So this Greyhound behind me, this MA Greyhound, its brakes are jammed on. Of course, we don't have time now because we're so far behind that they're going to have to be left here. And the wrecker, which is pulling up over there, are going to try and help them fix it. Maybe they'll join us at Bobbington. Or it could be a case of they're not going to get the RAC out. Anyway, good luck to these guys because I know what these old vehicles are like. They're fickle as anything. Got one of our fellow fat riders here. Your name is?
Mark.
Mark, this is Mark.
How are you doing?
He's got cracking little Triumph.
It's not that one.
Yes, it is that one. So Mark, first event, done this one before?
No, this is my third. Cool. Missed the last one, but first two I did.
Cool. So here's man's experience. Dave and I, we've reached Dorchester. It's been quite an epic journey so far. I am really dirty, and I look.
Yeah, not good.
Anyway, so as we were saying, the last
quarter mile was just the business. The whole thing's the business. Quarter mile, going through the crowds, waving, whistling, got my siren on, just Damien's here. On it.
So what, I'm just going to turn the camera around and show you the people. People that have gathered in Dorchester. When we did this 6 years ago, we led the carnival, but this year there's no carnival, but these people have come out for this epic sight. So like Dave says, part of whizzing up and down on the motorbikes is you get to use the bike for what it's actually made to be used for, but actually you feel kind of special.
Right. But not special needs.
Not special. No, just good special.
Look at our silly children grins. Anyway, more later. Hopefully I got some good footage of coming into town. I don't know if the GoPro actually got anything. It's so difficult because you can't stop, because once this thing is rolling, it just keeps on rolling.
It's great.
But anyway, let's see what I've got later on tonight. So we've been in Dorchester now for a couple of hours. Crowd have been able to come and look at the vehicles. We're just about to fire everything up. Wait till one of these big Sherman starts. It starts, it's an aircraft engine. Radio can make a lot of noise. Gotta do a piece to camera. Finally back after the long ride back. Interesting for sure. This is everything. An amazing day, hard work, because it is work. You're not just riding along, you're actually stopping traffic, whizzing up and down the outside of the convoy. I'm hoping I got some footage of that. It's been nice to be involved in this again. Whether it'll ever happen again or not, I don't know, but it's been fantastic. Big thanks to Jack and the Armour Embarkation team. I am hoping to collar him later so he can actually explain a little bit what this whole thing is all about, because I don't think I have at all, really. But it is to commemorate the build-up of troops for D-Day, which went off from Weymouth. So tomorrow this lot will go, I am really dirty, aren't I? Tomorrow this lot will head to Weymouth. I'll be packing up and going home. I'll do a few little interviews with people later on, including my mate Manny, who's avoiding me now because I've got the camera out. He's just over here, and his lovely Harley is just down there. I want to know is, did you have a good time?
I had a fantastic time. We made history today. To pick up on your earlier question, it was teamwork, right? It's not me, it's teamwork.
Jack and the team.
Everybody turned up today, including yourself, teamwork. And everybody worked just brilliantly. The reason I started it, because I was told you could never run tanks on British roads, because the Europeans do, that's not an issue. And we made it happen in 2010, and it's grown since then. And every time we've done one, it's always been the last one. This is the last one.
So I only did 2016, which was my first one, which I thought was the last one. But now this is the biggest.
The biggest.
And at the moment, the last one.
We made history today, without a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah.
This is exceptional. You don't see this stuff.
No, it was incredible.
I haven't seen any of this stuff. There's vehicles here, there's only two in the world. Most of them are here.
Yeah.
But everybody played their part. The DRs, the tankers, the marshals, everybody made it happen.
Let's talk DRs.
Let's talk about the gods of the road.
Aren't DRs the business?
I've got to tell you, mate, I ain't buttering you up, but we could not run an event like this without that skill and dedication, because it is dangerous.
It is.
It's like I said to you in the driver's brief this morning, tanks don't take prisoners.
No, tanks squish things like pfft.
And you can see this much out of a tank. To be fair, you can see much about this much about most military vehicles except for bikes.
But isn't that what most people see, because all there ever is on their phones like that?
Yeah.
That's all they see.
Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, picture. To get that amount of vehicles, if you're looking at tonnage, you're talking thousands of tons of armour.
And there was, what, 70-odd vehicles plus bikes.
Plus bikes, so we're running into the early 90s on vehicles.
Yeah.
And to get that organised, you have to rely on everybody else to get organised and believe in the event and know what they want to do. And everybody, without question, everybody done that.
And considering these vehicles are 70 to 80 years old,
yep,
very few breakdowns, very few issues really. Most vehicles started, most vehicles ran. Sherman shit its load one.
Yeah, we blew an engine on Sherman. And the issue
20
is,
grand for a rebuild.
Yeah, it's like, yeah. And Tilly said, I'll get another one shipped down next week.
Just like, you just do, like that.
Like you do, right?
A quick radial engine.
And if you think about a Sherman, two gallons to the mile.
2 gallons to the mile, not 2 miles to the gallon.
2 gallons to the mile.
Right, well, and that's more juicy than one of Royal Enfield.
Well, what fuel costs are now. So people just didn't turn up for a laugh. They were dedicated. They made this happen.
Yeah.
And being a DR, to go back to your question, that's not an easy job. That's a dangerous job, and there's a lot of responsibility in that job.
Yeah, I mean, I've been riding for a living for 30 odd years. I constantly filter through traffic. But riding an 80-year-old motorbike with the gears on the wrong side, the brakes that don't actually work. You have to write a letter to the brakes, so I'd like to stop at some point. Whizzing past tanks, who can't see you on country lanes, stopping traffic. It's quite a feat. It's actually very tiring. I could see some of the guys by...
They were done.
Yeah, absolutely done. For me, I'm conditioned to hours and hours and hours in the saddle, and I could see the people, they've just got this glazed look.
So just done.
For all of us to get back just in done. One piece, no accidents, no crashes, it's been an epic event.
Like I said to you in the driver's brief this morning, I'll get you there and I'll get you back.
Yeah.
And
might have been on a stretcher.
Yeah, it might have been on the back of a low loader or a stretcher, yeah. But we did, and no one complained, everybody got it done. And when we got to Dorchester, I cried 3 times in Dorchester.
Dorchester was just epic.
Overwhelming. See that amount of people there?
What was it? Half a mile into Dorchester?
Yeah.
I've got some footage of that. The streets were lined with people waving, cheering, photographs. And last time we did this, Dorchester Carnival was on. And we led the parade. This time, Dorchester shut down for this.
It was incredible. We've always, like you say, we've always piggybacked on the back of Dorchester Carnival. So when we turn up, we know we got a fan base there because they're there for the carnival. Mm. This time was one of my biggest stresses that we all turn up.
Nobody.
There's no one there.
Yeah.
We think there was 5,000 to 6,000 people there.
Yeah, pretty impressive.
And when we came over the bridge coming into Dorchester and I saw those people, I was gone, mate. I was dying.
But they started so far out of town.
Yeah, we've never ever seen that.
So there was people who've driven down from Salisbury. There was a guy that I know who's into the military vehicles. He's come down from Wales.
No way.
Yeah.
Is that the guy you were speaking with?
That was the guy I was chatting with. Yeah, he rides bikes and all that. And he's come down from Wales to just view this epic event.
When I left, right, you guys, you DR guys, pushed on front. And we pulled all the tanks out and all those vehicles out. I was the last man standing to make sure, because we had to get out by 5:30 because the road closure ends then. I had to make sure everybody's out. So I had a Jeep driver and the crew with me. And when we left, I just looked behind, it was like, I was a bit sad really, because all that buzz had gone, right? It was like a ghost town.
And was there patches of oil everywhere?
I didn't look at that.
we were given panty pads to put underneath the bikes and trucks. We saw all that
so pro on this one. And a guy came up
to me. I'm taking my two home because they're clean.
Yeah, do so, mate. A guy came up to me, he said, excuse me, sir. He said, are you the organiser? I said, I'm one of the organisers, thinking there's going to be an issue. He put his hand out, he said, thank you. I started crying. It's like,
so
it was like
2023.
No chance, mate.
Are we gonna see?
Right, you can end that right there.
Okay, you heard it here.
No,
they thanked him.
They thanked us, right?
They thanked us. Thank you and your team. Because what a lot of people don't realize, it's not just Jack. There is a whole group of these people who have tirelessly worked to put this together. I hope the wind noise isn't screwing us up.
We're done on that one, mate.
Anyway, so thank you very much
for
an amazing event.
No, mate, and thank you.
Jack's off on his travels to
Croatia
for a few months. Hopefully.
You can come down, right?
I'd like to come down.
Yeah.
Until next time.
Yeah, thank you.
See you at the next Armour and Embarkation.
Nope, we'll end that there.
Bye-bye.